Hello friends, welcome to Study to Win. Myself Sanjay Bhosle, and let us start with our lecture, Taylor's Principle of Gauge Design. Before we start with the Taylor's Principle, let us understand what the limit gauges are. There are two types of limit gauges, go and no-go gauges, used for inspecting the size of a component and deciding whether the component is accepted or rejected. Go gauge is always made for maximum material limit, and go gauge should always pass through the component if the part is accepted. And no go gauge is made for minimum material limit, and no go gauge should never pass through the component or should never enter to the component if the part is accepted. If go gauge doesn't enter, means the material present on the part is more than the maximum permissible material and the part should be sent for the rework. And if no go gauge enters into the part, means the material present on the part is lesser than the minimum material, and that means the part is scrap because it is over machined and which cannot be reworked. Look at this picture. This picture has, this is a hole with its tolerance zone and this is a shaft with its tolerance zone. A gauges for hole is in, looks like this. This is called as a plug gauges. This side is go gauge, this side is no go gauge. Go gauge side is always longer than the no go gauge side. If it is not written on the gauges, you can still identify by looking at its length. Lengthier side is always a go gauge side and short side is always a no go gauge side. This go gauge side will be manufactured for maximum material limit. For shaft gauges will be in the form of rings and for hole gauges will be in the form of plugs. We will not talk about these gauges here. Consider this part, this is a hole, and go gauge will be formed for maximum material limit, that means the lower limit of this hole, and no go gauge will be made for maximum material limit of this hole. So if the material present on the shaft is more than material present on this hole is more than the maximum permissible limit, then no go gauge will not enter into the component. That means the material present is more than the maximum permissible material. Go gauge will not enter the component because go gauge is made for maximum material limit size. Similarly, and in that case, the component can be sent for rework. And no go gauge is made for minimum material limit. And if the material present on the component is lesser than the minimum permissible limit or the minimum material limit, then no go gauge will enter into the hole. That means the part is scrap because we cannot add on material again on the part. So this is how we inspect the gauges. Now let us move towards the Taylor's principle of gauge design. So before we go to the Taylor's principle, there is a something called as a basic principle of gauge design. What it says? It says that the design of gauges should be such that it should not reject. No rejected part will be accepted, but there is no problem in rejecting accepted parts. Means a gauging should be such that it is having no problem, or it is even ready to reject some accepted part, but the gauges should not accept any rejected part. This is what the basic principle says. And what Taylor's principle says is a go gauge should be made for maximum material limit. That we have already seen, a gauge should be made for maximum material limit, and it has to accommodate as many dimensions as possible to inspect in one pass. That means the go gauge should be in such a fashion that it should be made for maximum material limit, and it should accommodate as many possible dimensions as it can inspect in one pass. Similarly, a no go gauge should be made for minimum material limit, and a separate no-go gauge should be made for each separate dimension to be inspected. Let us understand this Taylor's principle with one example here. Here in this particular slide, this blue color part is nothing but a part that we want to inspect. And in this is some square part, and in that some rectangular part, and in that some rectangular hole is there. And our job is to design a gauges for this rectangular hole, if it is within tolerance zone or not. And the dimensions for this rectangular hole are 25 and 35, let us say mm. And the tolerances on both the dimensions are plus and minus 0.5. So now let us follow the Taylor's principle and design the gauges. So this is a go gauge for this particular hole, the rectangular hole, and this is the no go gauge. As per Taylor's principle, the go gauge should be made for maximum material limit. So since this is a hole, friends, always remember the hole and shaft term in metrology are only a indicative terms. Hole cannot be always a circular hole and shaft cannot be always a circular shaft. There can be these are the terms used for assembly purpose only. So here we have a square hole, and all the concepts of lower limit, upper limit, maximum material limit, minimum material limit can be equally applied to this case also. Here the maximum material limit for this case is a lower limit, that means 24.5. so 24.5, and here maximum material limit for this side is 34.5. so this is 34.5. so go gauge is made for maximum material limit, and that as the next sentence Taylor's principle says, the go gauge should incorporate as many possible dimensions as it can. That means here there are only two dimensions, so here this go gauge accommodate that two dimensions in it. Now let us design a no go gauge. No go gauge is designed for minimum material limit, and it should be separate for separate dimensions. So here we have already made the no go gauges for minimum material limit, and minimum material limit is nothing but upper limit of this particular part. So this is the minimum material limit, that is 35.5 for this dimension. I named it as a no go 1, and for this dimension there is a no go 2 which has a dimension 25.5. so this is the Taylor's principle. We have complied with Taylor's principle and we have made a gauge design. But let us prove if this Taylor's principle is true to obey the basic principle of gauge design. For that purpose, in engineering there is always a trick to prove something. We have to violate it and check what results we get. If we are getting the negative results, that means we have to obey the principle. So with the same principle, what I have done here is, for the same component I have not complied with the Taylor's principle and I made a gauge designs. And now then let us see if we are following the basic principle or not. If we are not following the principle, basic principle, that means we should follow Taylor's principle. Now for this particular part, I have made a two separate go gauges and one no go gauge. Obviously go gauge is made for maximum material limit and no go gauge is made for minimum material limit, but I have made two go gauges and single no gauge. Now as per a Taylor's principle, suppose if I try to inspect a part with this no go gauge, let us see what results we get. Look at here, friends, I am trying to insert this no go gauge inside this part. It is not going in. But suppose this particular dimension, which as talking about this 35, this 35 dimension is instead of 35.5, suppose it is 36, but this 25 dimension is within limit. If this is the case, this particular dimension is out of limit and this particular dimension is within limit, and I have made a single go no go gauge for both the dimension, in that case I am trying to insert this no go gauge inside the part, it will not go in. The reason is that even if this dimension is out of specification, but because of this dimension is within specification, this side of no go gauge will not allow it to enter. Even if this side it would have entered, by looking at the picture itself you can identify the go gauge is not entering because this dimension is true, but it should enter because this dimension is wrong. This dimension is out of specification, so this is giving us a wrong picture that the part is accepted because no go gauge is not entering, but actually no go gauge should enter because this dimension is not correct. This dimension is suppose it is beyond the limit, but it is not entering only because we have incorporated more than one dimension in a no go gauge. Means we have not followed the Taylor's principle, we are getting wrong result. Let us try this for go gauge also. So this is a go gauge. Suppose I am trying to enter, and it is not going in. This is the case. So no go gauge is not entering. Hello friends, welcome to Study to Win. Myself Sanjay Bhosle, and I am going to share a Taylor's principle of gauge design in this particular session. So let us start with our session. Before we start with the Taylor's principle, let us understand what the gauging means. Gauging, there are two types of gauges. One is a go gauge and no go gauge. These are used to inspect the limit sizes of the part and to comment if the part is accepted or rejected. That is the purpose of gauges or limit gauges. In that, go gauge is always made for maximum material limit and no go gauge is made for minimum material limit. Go gauge, as the name suggests, it should always enter into the part, and no go gauge, as the name suggests, it should never enter into the part to say if the part is accepted. If the go gauge doesn't enter into the part, part is rejected. If no go gauge enters into the part is rejected. But if go gauge doesn't enter into the part is not totally rejected, because the material present on the part is more than the maximum permissible limit. That means we can obviously rework it and bring it to the size. But whenever no go gauge enters into the component, the part is absolutely scrap. Here, this picture shows a hole and a shaft, and this particular is a gauges. For hole, the gauges is always in the form of plug. These are called as a plug gauges. And for shaft, the gauges is always in the form of ring. These are called as a ring gauges. Let us not talk about this particular shaft and gauges here. Let us concentrate on this hole and gauges here. So this is a hole, and this is a lower limit, and this is the upper limit. For hole, lower limit is a maximum material limit, and upper limit is a minimum material limit. For this particular part, a go gauge is made for maximum material limit, that means for lower dimension or the lower limit of a hole tolerance. And upper limit, we produce a no go gauge, that is minimum material limit. Here, by looking at the gauge, we will not identify which side is go gauge, which side is no go gauge, unless until it is written on it. But there is a small observation if you can make. If the lengthier the size of a the go gauge side is always lengthy than the no go gauge sides. No go gauge is a shorter in length than the go gauge. So this you can, with this way you can identify which is a go side and which is a no go side. So this go side gauge, if you are trying to insert into the component, if the material present on the component is a more than less than the maximum permissible material limit, the go gauge will enter and the part is accepted, provided the no go gauge doesn't enter. And no go gauge will not enter if the material present in the part is more than the minimum material limit, and then we can say totally the part is accepted. Any of this condition doesn't follow, the part is either we have to rework it or it is scrap. Now let us start with our Taylor's principle of gauge design. Before we start again actual Taylor's principle, understand what the basic principle of gauge design says. Basic principle of gauge design is nothing but there is a no problem in rejecting accepted part, but we cannot accept any rejected part. This is what the basic principle says. And what the Taylor's principle says, it says gauge should be made for maximum material limit, and this we have already seen, but it adds a one more sentence, important sentence, that it has to incorporate as many dimensions as possible to inspect in one pass. Who? Go gauge. Go gauge has to incorporate as many dimensions as possible to inspect in one pass, and no go gauge can be made for minimum material limit, and separate no go gauge should be made for each separate dimension of a part. Let us understand this particular statements with example. Now this is a example which I have taken. This is some part in which there is a square hole, and on this square hole there are two dimensions. One is 25 and another is the 35 with the tolerance on both the dimensions, that is plus minus 0.5. Now complete a gauge design complying with Taylor's principle of gauge design. So what our principle says, the go gauge is made for maximum material limit, and no go gauge should be made for minimum material limit. So maximum material limit for whole case is always lower limit. So here 24.5 and here 34.5 are the lower limits with which the go gauge is made. No go gauge is always made for minimum material limit, and minimum material limit for this case is always upper limit. So 25.5 and 35.5 are the dimensions with which the go gauges are made. As the Taylor's principle says, go gauge should incorporate as many possible dimensions as it can. So there are two dimensions which is supposed to be inspected, and go gauge incorporate all those two dimensions in one pass. Similarly, no go gauge should be made for separate dimensions, and that is what it is followed here. For this dimensions I have made no go 1, and for this dimensions I have made no go 2. So this is how you should complete a gauge design with Taylor's principle. But if we are really getting the correct results by obeying the Taylor's principle or not can be proved by considering if we are not following the Taylor's principle and we are getting the negative results, that means we should obey the Taylor's principle. So this is the way you can prove the Taylor's principle. So here is the gauge design in which I have not complied with the Taylor's principle. That means I have not followed Taylor's principle. And in this case, if I am not obeying a basic principle of gauge design, that means I should always obey Taylor's principle to obey basic principle of gauge design. That means to accept a accepted part and reject a rejected parts. Now here I have made a no-go gauge combined for all the possible dimensions, that is two dimensions here, and I have made a separate go gauges for separate dimension. So I am not complying with the Taylor's principle, that is why I have done this. But I have made go and no go gauges with maximum material limit and minimum material limit. Now let us start if we are getting the correct result with this case or not. Now this is a no go gauge, and if I try to align it with the part, look at here friends, consider this dimension is not within the specification. That means consider this dimension, instead of 35.5 it is 36. That means the material present is lesser than the minimum permissible limit. In that case the go gauge, no go gauge should enter actually in that case, but because this dimension is within limit, the no go gauge will not enter, because no go gauge is made combined for both the dimensions. Here the picture itself is clear. Here actually no go gauge should enter because this dimension is longer than the no go gauge dimension, but no go gauge is not entering into the component only the reason because of this dimension. These edges are preventing it to enter into the component, but a person will not understand if the part is rejected. He will consider that part is accepted only because no go gauge is not entering into the component, but actually that is not true. It is not entering, only the reason is that this dimension is within limit, but Before we can always say the part is accepted only if all the dimensions on the part is correct. So this is giving us a wrong result by combining the two dimensions in a no go gauge. Let us try the similar case with the go gauge. The go gauge is made for maximum material limit. Here if you see, the go gauge is not entering into the component. Consider this is a go gauge which is higher than the part and it is not entering into the component. Only the reason that if the part dimension is lower than the minimum dimension, that means minimum dimension here is 24.5, and if it is part dimension is lesser than that, if it is considered it is 24 only, then the go gauge will not enter. I am showing the exaggerated cases, but understand we are dealing with microns, so this can happen. So this go gauge is not entering into the component because the part is not within tolerance zone. The material present is more than the maximum permissible limit. But what happens actually, if we make separate go gauges for separate dimension, we may get little bit tilt on this go gauge and go gauge will enter into the component. Like if this is a situation, the go gauge gets tilted, it may enter into the component and we will get a wrong impression that the go gauge is entering into the component and the dimension is correct. This what I have shown is very exaggerated case. The go gauge will not tilt in such a fashion, but to a micro level this can happen, tilting a go gauge and then entering into the component. This is not a correct way to inspect it. So that is the reason we should always make a go gauge which will incorporate as many dimensions as it can, so there will not be a tilting of go gauge or avoiding a of entering the no go gauge because of any one of the dimensions. This kind of cases will not occur if we follow a Taylor's principle of gauge design. So this case is correct because if we don't obey the Taylor's principle, we are getting the wrong results. We are accepting a rejected parts. That means we should always obey Taylor's principle for a complete and correct gauge design. So this was all from my side about the Taylor's principle. Friends, if you like this video, please like, share and subscribe this channel. And thank you for watching. Have a great day.